Okay, so in an attempt to clear off some piles, I'm now going to make this particular review about three completely separate yet very similar devices. So we have, sent to me from Hi-Fi Express, the Savage A20A. You remember the A10A? I have it on the shelf back there. It's one I'm like, this thing is great, except for the blue, and I'll keep it. And I got a bigger one coming. Here's the bigger one. I've got the A20D, the DAC, that goes with this. There is a headphone amp. I asked them if they would have it, and they said they're not going to have it until September, so I'm not waiting until September to do the full stack, so we're just doing this right now. Which, by the way, the headphone amp has the outputs in the back, which is real weird, but I'm kind of into it. And then finally, from Ayoshida Audio, which is a new company that wants to sell, or a new retailer that wants to send me things, here is the AO200 from SMSL. Didn't we just do the DA9Zios from SMSL? Yes, we did. I don't know. Companies just send me this stuff, and it's my job to figure out why. Not why they sent it to me. I know why they sent it to me. I got to figure out why the hell, like, SMSL keeps making the same fucking amp over and over and over again. Because it's good. It's actually, on the website, it's actually cheaper than the DA9. Wait, $251. How much was it? Wasn't the exact same price than the DA9? And then we've got the, here's the amp, here's the DAC, this thing, which is MQA compatible, $376, so that's expensive. And then this amp, which is like this giant box, and you're like, oh my God, Zios, does it have infinite power? Not really. Also $196. So this is $200, this is nearly $400, and this is $250. So actually, what's the power rating it claims on this? Does it not show it here on this website? At no extra cost, Savage model. Oh, maximum power per channel. Claims 200 watts, but that's going to be in 2 ohms. They're always at 2 ohms. I love to poop out that those high values at 2 ohms. Let's look around the back, just because I'm sitting on a ball. Link in the description to the ball. It's real comfortable, guys. You got to give it a shot. What I've got going on here. Because I was just going to do this, and then, all right, I'll do this, and I'll do this. And that's like, if I do a Monday, then it's a Wednesday, then I can't do new video until Friday. So let's fucking combine them all. Good DAC. I trust the output of it. Like, I'm pretty much trusting of, like, all DAC outputs, unless you have a real problem. So I've got this balance output into these Emotiva splitter boxes. I can actually link these, I think. Full metal boxes into the world's best XLRs. And this one does the both right channels. This one does both left channels. Feeding balance into this, balance into this. These will also accept... I love how all of them have RCAs and all of them have black-centered RCAs. But they're different companies. And we know that they're different companies 100%. Because the remote controls look nothing alike. This one's definitely shinier than this one. And the... I guess I'll just go over all of this now while I'm here. The difference between this and the DA9 is the DA9 had a Bluetooth input, but no digital inputs. It was just a straight amp. This has a digital input. It comes with this wire. You're not hallucinating. That is the USB cable it comes with, and it has a built-in DAC. Now, I'm not using that because you can use it. I guarantee it's fine. It's fine. That is actually means that if you're getting a DA9 or this, this has a digital input. And you don't lose this cable because God knows where you're going to find that. So that's one of the differences. It also, for some reason, has 2 subwoofer outs. I think, and I feel like they just made it have 2 subwoofer outs simply because it was easier to get the 2 RCA binding posts like this. Because it doesn't separate left and right subwoofer, and it still doesn't cut off the highs. And by the way, we're using these. Not vintage. Is it vintage when it's out of stock or discontinued? Because they're not that old. They're like 2010 vintage. RB81 2s, which are an 8-inch. So we're using those to pump out, kick up the tunes. So XLR ins, RCA ins, 2 subwoofer outs. Here's your antenna. There's your USB slot, which is fucking no sense. Here's your 5-way binding posts, your power input, and your switch. That's what the SMSL has. Now the DAC, I don't have the antenna on for the Wi-Fi or for the Bluetooth because I didn't bother. Bluetooth is probably fine on everything. I do have, however, the coaxial digital. Oh God, the coaxial digital in use, coming off of the back of the Sabah. Which one are you? No, not Sabah. You're the Soncos SGD1. This unit actually has II2S, the HDMI input, optical, full-size USB, the 15-volt power supply. We'll get to that in a second. And then we have our XLR and RCA outs. That's the back of this. Walking around the table. Finally into the A20A, which I was really interested in. But it doesn't have much more power than like the DA9 or that AO20, which is why I'm using it. Here, we've got big old power switch and plug. There's your five-way binding posts. Here's your singular subwoofer out, RCA. Here is the power supply jumping to the DAC. So this actually has a built-in 15-volt DC converter. Not sure if that's linear, but I'm powering the DAC off of the speaker amp, that's okay. And then you have the RCA inputs and the XLR inputs. So they really want you to marry these two things together. And so they give you, basically the power brick is in this. You plug only this in, and then this feeds power to this. And I guess the headphone amp would be powered separately because there isn't like a second output from this, unless it comes with a Y splitter. Sabaj has got some weird shit going on in the brains. I like the way it sounds though, but here's the thing. I have this all set up. Just showed you how it's all laid out. I'm splitting the signal from this to both of these. And I was switching the wires back and forth and forth and back and back and forth. And I can't tell the difference. I can't tell you the difference in how they sound. And it got to the point where I just put the right speaker on this one and the left speaker on this one. And I was like, all right, let me balance it so they sound like they're perfectly in the center by putting it in mono. Both at 30. Both at 30. I mean, this one's at negative 30 and it goes up to zero. And this one goes from 30 up to 70. I just thought that was fucking weird. Like, I can't tell apart audibly. I can't tell apart audibly. And then I'm pushing the volumes like perfect. Then I was controlling the volumes with this, which, by the way, I really need to get the book because the last time I did the Sabaj DAC, it was like, all right, example, let me take the camera from my head first. We want to go into the menu of this. So this unit just has the button there. So we have pretty easy to look at input. You pick which input and you have, you know, USB, unbalanced, balanced, Bluetooth, etc. And then EQ is the standard EQ fare. And then, you know, I want to direct where there's no sound. Bass and treble would then be affected without direct. Soft clipping, we've discussed the last episode where soft clipping, if you have that on, it'll actually limit the amplifier from getting too loud and causing the speakers to clip. So that's a good thing. And then you have the dimmer, which will actually shut the screen off either never or every after, you know, what, 60 seconds to have it off. Because why would you? Or because I'm doing a review and brightness of the screen. The end. Done. Now, the Sabaj stuff, that's a little different. See, that's your input. Input one or two. And then E1 through 5. And then here's your treble, because that's the letter T. And there's your bass. And there's your BL, which is blue. And then we're back to input. So that's the settings for this. Now this, which is a $400 DAC, has a similar... all right, ready? Do this with me, everybody. In 4, filter FL1, we'll just do filter 1, DPL, DPL, or DPI, okay, so then we got NOR, or RL, or LR, so either it's RL or LR, I figured that out. Then we have P15, and this is, I know what that is, because that's the pin for the II2S. You know, when you have the input, you could choose either 15 or 14. And then the blue level, which is, it's so fucking blue. I hate how blue it gets. Keep it on the lowest and then in. So that is the least luxurious way to navigate a $400 DAC. It sounds good. Like, here's the thing. It sounds good. I'm not going to knock it for how it sounds. It's just that there are obviously better ways to go about anything. It's me in the ball. It's not, I'm not passing wind on the video. It's just, I'm trying to sit in the ball. It's good for your back. Let's listen to some music. Well, let's shuffle off of Billy Joel. Because we really... can't listen to too much music because YouTube's a pile of crap that blocks everything. Or they just ban it from channels. So, there's no high-low gain. So, it's just whatever it is, it is. And as efficient as clips usually are, these are taking quite a bit of power to make them go. Those eights. Okay, that was a lot. Let's back that up. Let's have that exact same experience here. Excuse me. I should build a switch box. I could switch box. So let's see. I was at 25 and this said it was the same at 30. So I'm going to take this at 35 and we'll back that up and play that again. Ah, the subwoofers are attached here. I'm going to undo that. By the way, that's Dragon Ball Z Frieza. Frieza Bass. That's a terrible name for a song, but that is the name of that song. I can't play music to you guys because it's YouTube. You can't do it. And all I could do is tell you that I did play music over and over and over again, back and forth and back and forth. And if there is an audible change between this one and this one, it is so minute. And maybe I need harder drive speakers. Maybe there's a speaker somewhere in my vicinity that'll make one of these two amps shine greater than the other. But you're looking at like such a small price difference between 200. And keep in mind, this has no Bluetooth, no USB in, so you're getting less features, but similar power to this, almost identical power to it, honestly. I had to look them up on their individual websites to get like full-on power details, because Hi-Fi Express is not doing a fantastic job. And what about Yoshida? See, Yoshida has a very, very long, Jesus Christ. Standby power. Yeah, 150 watt at 2 ohms. Same thing. They're the same thing. They're both using the Infineon drivers. They're both doing the exact same. I brought this up. I think it was on my Discord. Someone was like, what's the difference between this and this amp? And I'm like, well, they're both Infineon drivers. And they're both pretty much I think they were the same company. It was both SMSLs. So it's like, why? Just pick the one that has the nicer... pick the one you like the form factor of better or the features you like better. So, like, you can get Bluetooth on this DAC and then run this DAC to this amp, but this DAC is $400. The stack on top of this $200 amp, where this, while if you just want Bluetooth to a set of speakers, you can get DA9 or this or Lox GA30 or there's so many. Just list them in the comments. How many speaker amps? That's why I'm doing three at a time. I pick a great wallpaper, available in the description, by the way. And let's do three at a time because I'm going to just blurt out my opinion on everything here. And we can compare directly because if I did a whole video on this and then a whole video on this and a whole video on this, that's old school Zeos. This new school Zeos is like, just give me it. If I had to choose between this stack and this one unit, because presumably you'd use, I wish it had, if this had a fiber optic input, then it would be a no-brainer. But since it's USB only and weird as fuck USB only, it's sort of like a half win for the AO2. I still can't. I'm reading it. AO200. I'm reading it. It's like AO200. It doesn't match any of the other things that SMSLs put out. I like the case, by the way. The case feels very, very similar to their VMV line, the one I just did, the VMV A1, where it's a single piece of aluminum all the way around with four bolts in the front. It's a different fascia, and you know, it doesn't have the power button that glows in the middle. Wait, hold on. It doesn't have that, which I actually like this. By the way, turning this off turns this off. So I like that when it's on the SMSL stuff, but now they just, it's just nothing. It's just off. Slightly cleaner knob. I wish the knob stuck out a little farther. If you want to go with a build problem, I like to grab a knob. Please don't take that out of context. And this is a little stubby knob. This is a little stubby knob. It's an even stubbier knob. SMSL. Do I have to hold it? All right, so that says 828, and that's an 820D. Boom, 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 boom. That's Nine Inch Nails. It's supposed to sound like that. As far as the subs go, which I have both those Martin Logan Dynamo 300s wired together in the back, and then one loop coming out here to this. So if I... Yeah, as far as I can tell, they don't have any different outputs. I thought it'd be cool if they had two subwoofer outputs, and one would be like completely cut off, you know, and then lower the speakers, and one would be like, all right, not lower the speakers again. But no, they just didn't want to find a single RC. I don't understand. Are they trying to sell that as like, oh, you can get a 2.2 out of this? Because as far as I could tell audibly from just plugging back and if I unplug this, and if we disconnect the hots, there's the bottom sub. And there's a top sub. And there's the bottom sub. If I unplug, there's the right one is out. So it isn't like left and right subs or anything. It's just two. They just give you two. So, I mean, we're back here again. I have so many fingerprints on this. With the Zeos. Thank you for doing all these in one go so I could choose and decide. Because I want to thank Aoshita for sending me this. They're going to send me some other stuff. And I'm glad I got to play with this because no one else was offering. But it's one of those like, well, didn't I just do like nine fucking things that are like this? Because I'm not going to say no. I'm not going to say, oh, you don't want this. I've done other things. Just do that. By the way, I'm plugging these back. It's Nine Inch Nails. Play the goddamn part. Nice. I like angry sounding titles of music. Can't play enough Childish Gambino. We're gonna get blocked. Oh my god. So I guess I'm gonna literally cut this video short. I know it's three fucking whole units and people have been excited for at least this one. I know people are abuzz about. But it's literally the same as every other Infineon Class D speaker amp. And that means it's great. Swear to Christ, it's Jesus. The German Infineon drivers have basically made cheat mode. Because I have those vintage monoblocks, those vintage Marantz monoblocks, and they're clean and great sounding. But at the same volumes, before you're really pushing it, these are clean and great sounding. They're just like, okay, just great. Just fucking, they're great. So now you're just imagining with features. So you have tone controls in this. You've got tone controls in this. There's cat hair on me. This requires a DAC to have Bluetooth. This does not require a DAC to have Bluetooth. This also has USB in. This also has better, way, way better menu selections. Holy God. Like you could actually read them. They're in English. You could just quickly choose. You don't have to like get the runes to figure out what the fucking runes mean. What is what even? Oh God, my eyes. It just, I want to scratch my eyes. Because Sauvage, I like their A10A because it's simple. And the A20A is also simple, but it's not any more powerful. It just adds balanced inputs. And they shoved a 15 volt transformer inside of it so they could feed this out. And that's it. All they've done is made the box bigger, added a 15-volt transformer for the DAC, and added balanced inputs, which all amplifiers, by the way, all speaker amplifiers are quote-unquote balanced internally, like the way they're wired. I don't think you can make them not balanced. So it just comes down to, does this benefit, does the AO200 have any benefits over the DA9 besides the USB? Not in sound. The end. So yeah, they're three black boxes. There are three black boxes that do their job. This is a little bit pricey. The non-balanced outputting one was still a little bit pricey. They were both pricey, actually, come to think of it. I will link on Hi-Fi Express all the Sabaj stuff. And I will link on Aoshita all the SMSL stuff, including the competitors to this, which if you look, Aoshita has like everything. Here, this is, look, I looked up SMSL. There's 4, 8, 16, 20. There's 20 items. Let's see how many of those are amplifiers. The AO20, the A2 power amplifier, which is, I just did the A1, right? You remember I did the A1 up in the mezzanine? There's a fucking A2 for $1,000. What does it do differently? It has USB in and optical. So they make it, basically, this is the next level up because it has everything and is the VMV series. Then there's the DAC, which I have over there. Then there's the SA400, high resolution power amplifier. Did I do that? Is that the other one I'm thinking about? There it is again. There's the SA400. They're all the, there's so many of the same things. Then the 8018 is still there. So that's another like Bluetooth speaker amp. That's $130. So like that at least lives at the bottomest most tier of cost. M500s, M100s, Sanskrit 10s. Actually, the Sanskrit 10s are going to go for the monoblocks. M100, SP200, M200, M400, DP5. Don't know. And then there's the Tabula, which are the SMSL apparently speakers that I didn't know they made. And what's the A6? Digital headphone amp. Okay, I think we've covered all of the speaker amps that SMSL makes. That is not including other Infineon drivered amps from Topping. Actually, you know, Topping hasn't really stepped foot into the speaker amp quota, have they? Not recently. They used to have them, but now it's sort of like it's just SMSL's game. And now Sabaj, which is definitely 100% not an offshoot of SMSL. Completely different things. Although I'm pretty sure these remotes are just handed out like popcorn if you go over to the manufacturing areas of China. So, yeah, take your pick. Either you want flat box that makes sound good, or big tall box that makes sound good, or DAC that is MQA with II2S. It all sounds great. It all sounds great, but nothing sounds like at least the VMVA1 that was $600 had a slight warming. It had way less power. It was like fucking 10 watts per channel, but it was class A or a very, very biased class AB to class A. So that had at least something. In fact, I'd love to hook these speakers up to that because we're pushing these pretty hard. And I guarantee you that thing would push them and just be like, oh. In fact, I have to go and do the DAC for the VMV. So maybe I'll grab that DAC and the amp and then hook it up to these speakers or so. We're done here. Everybody, get this wallpaper. See this wallpaper? See this wonderful wallpaper? Originally, it was going to be used for the Klipsch because, you know, heavy duty. But now we'll use that good one for these. And I'm going to move on with my life. Now I got to take a picture of a thumbnail of this and figure out how I'm titling it so it gets any number of views. Because it's like, this is like an angry review, but I like everything. I'm more angry at the concept that there's so many copies of the same thing and I have to keep reviewing them. And the companies, I want them to keep sending them to me. I don't want them to not, because maybe there'll be something in there that's just really interesting. Like the headphone amp part of this. The plugs are all in the back. Balanced quarter inch and I think 4.4 are on the back. I want to review it just for that reason. And because the A10H was a very good headphone amplifier. It was super clean. It was had no noise at all. So a slightly better version of that would be welcome. I just wish this had more power, like real more power. Like 100 watts per channel at 8 ohms would be like, okay, that's the pick. But they're all, you know, 40 watts per channel, 45, 50 watts per channel at 8 ohms. And then they're like, no, but 150 ohms at 2 ohms. 150 watts at 2 ohms. No one's running 2 ohms anything. You're not. No one's running that. It's a bullshit figure. Don't even give it to us. If you're running a 2 ohm load, please, in the comments, tell me why you're running a 2 ohm load and what the hell is wrong with you. Links to all these from the various websites that have sent them to me. I'll even link to these speakers on eBay. And the mouse pad mat Zeos, because I needed something to cover this temporary table down here. So yeah, I'm good. I'm gonna stand up. I'm gonna kick my ball. This is what I do. Kick my ball. Look, I'm playing kick with the Harris with the RF7s. Good boy. Anyway, I'm done. You done? Patreon and Subscribestar. If you like the way I do these videos, I don't really do them in a way that. It's very profitable from the internet because I curse and say fuck and there's anime titties. So please feel free to support this channel via Patreon and Subscribestar. Will you see videos early and participate in yard sales, which lots of this stuff will probably end up in yard sales, which happens from the 1st to the 10th of every month. I ship for free international. I ship for free continental United States. It's half shipping international. And it's just name your bid, and when if you win, then you get an email and an invoice, and you pay it, and it's done. And then I charge you for the shipping if you're international. But yeah, that's from the 1st to the 10th of every month. I have a big pile of stuff that goes out. So I want to thank all the companies that send me shit and then don't ask for it back because they fuel the yard sales. Patreon subscribers, the $5 tier lets you see reviews early. The $10 tier gets you in the behind-the-scenes private Telegram chat, where if you'd like to ask me any questions and actually get a response, like guaranteed, like you pay for it, join the $10 tier and then get into Telegram, into the private behind-the-scenes Telegram chat, where I will help you and the other 300 people there will help you. We all want to help you. And we all have different opinions. We all have different needs and wants. We all will understand your problems differently. It's great. It's a beautiful family little attitude there. We do this. It's like multi-scissoring discounts. So yeah, there's that. And don't forget to check out Hi-Fi Guides and the Hi-Fi Guides forum. Hopefully we figured out that two-factor authentication thing that was going wrong back at the end of June. When people were getting locked to their accounts, including the mods, it was fantastic. It was work. Apparently time on the server matters. Server time. So yeah, links, wallpaper, speakers, and mouse pads, and I will see you in 2 days, maybe with a fresh head or some weird, wild, experimental video. It'll be great. It's going to be great.